in thick smog as residents continue to burst firecrackers on Diwali despite the Supreme Court's order. The air quality has deteriorated to hazardous levels, with the overall air quality index, or the AQI, being recorded at 999 this morning. Just remember, you cannot clock beyond 999, which also means that it perhaps is more than 999 this morning. The Supreme Court had allowed the bursting of firecrackers from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. only on Diwali. It has also allowed manufacture and sale of only green crackers, which have low light and sound emission and less harmful chemicals as well. And as the national capital wakes up to a toxic post-Diwali morning, CNN News 18's Uday Rana brings you this report. Here's a look.
Pollution to itna hai, hum yahan sair karne aate na. Khansi itni zabardast ho rakhi hai. Baki mood rakh ke hum sair kar rahe hain.
Problem to hai hi, ab kya kiya jaye isme? Isi mein hame walk karna hai, sab karna hai. Efforts to kar rahi hai government, lekin pure ho nahi pa rahe efforts. लेकिन इस बार तो रिलेटिवली बेटर है लास्ट ईयर से.
हाँ, तो पटाखे बजेंगे तो पोल्यूशन तो बढ़ेगा ही ना.
बहुत ज्यादा खतरा आप देख ही सकते हैं, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो फील इट इन योर ब्रीदिंग. बट दिस इज ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ आवर ओन डूइंग. जब हम लोगों को ही नहीं है कि हमको अच्छी एयर चाहिए, क्वालिटी चाहिए, यहाँ तो कोई आप रूल बनाए तो लोगों को मजा आता है कि हम इसको फ्लाउट कर लिया, हमने इसको तोड़ दिया, अब देखो प्राइड लेते.
All right, the air quality that we're breathing in Delhi goes from bad to worse. You and I are breathing toxic air quality in Delhi. AQI levels, or the air quality index, is going above 999 levels. Remember, 999 is that Markov point beyond which you cannot monitor, which means that the air quality in Delhi as we speak is higher than 999 in many pockets of Delhi NCR. We saw brazenly that the rules were flouted, the Supreme Court order was not followed, there was lack of enforcement as far as the Supreme Court order was concerned. The citizens continue to burst the crackers. The crackers were available in the silos as well if you wanted to buy them, and this whole green cracker bit ended up being just a lip service as far as Delhi NCR is concerned. Because you saw this morning as well, I was myself driving down to work, and it was, the entire street was engulfed in thick smog. The residents are continuing to burst firecrackers even last night on Diwali despite that Supreme Court order. There is breathing difficulty also that many citizens are complaining of. Uday Rana is joining us live from DND. DND in fact happens to be one place where the smog is very, very thick. I saw it myself this morning, Uday.
Certainly, Chaitya. You know, now as the sun has come out, the smog has sort of dissipated. But even now, if I look over to that side, you know, that is supposed to be Kalindi Kunj. And at this point in the day, usually the houses in Kalindi Kunj are very clearly visible. But even now, you can see that parts of the city are engulfed in smog. And it's 9 a.m. By now, the sun should be shining bright. And this is because today, the levels of pollution in Delhi, particularly PM 2.5, have breached hazardous levels. Now, remember, Chaitya, PM 2.5 is one of the smallest kinds of pollutants ever that are there. And the reason they are so dangerous is precisely because of their size. You know, they're so small, they're so tiny that they can make their way into your respiratory tract. They cannot be filtered by your nose. They're that small. And, you know, they're likely to cause the most amount of damage. And those levels in Delhi today, you know, somewhere it's 800, somewhere it's 900, somewhere it's 999, which essentially means that pollution levels in Delhi are so high that the scale is not big enough to measure the kind of pollution that exists in certain parts of Delhi. Some of the worst hit areas being Anand Vihar Srinivaspuri and Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium and Okhla industrial area, and as well as several residential areas across the city. Now, pollution levels weren't as bad as they are today, as far as yesterday is concerned. But then again, these are all relative numbers and figures that, even if it wasn't severe, it was still very poor. And very poor is also not the kind of condition that you would want to live in. But today, it has gone from bad to worse to hazardous, Chaiti, I'm afraid. And that is the kind of Diwali hangover that Delhi is having today.
You know, Uday, this is no longer news. Delhi air quality being bad is no longer news. The question really is that when there was a Supreme Court order in place to be able to only buy, sell, manufacture and use green crackers, the law was being flouted. And what was the enforcement looking like? Is it safe to say that there was poor enforcement on part of the officials? Uday, can you hear me? All right, we've lost the connection right there to Uday. We'll be joined by Uday in just about a bit. But Runjun is joining live from Akshardham. I'm going to take that same question back to Runjun now. Runjun, Akshardham is one place which is recording AQI levels of 999. It is hazardous. Toxic air is something that is in the air this morning. And that's the post-Diwali hangover we are talking about. The problem is the poor enforcement. Is it safe, Runjun, to conclude that there was poor enforcement despite the Supreme Court order?
Now, of course, Chayati, I can talk about the area that I live in, which is East Delhi. Now, people started bursting crackers way before 8 p.m., which was the cap given by Supreme Court, 8 to 10 p.m. Now, they kept on bursting crackers throughout the night. I could hear crackers post midnight. So we're talking about a two-hour cap that was given by the Supreme Court, very, very openly flouted by the citizens. Of course, there was no police intervention, but the point is also, let's talk about, you know, the citizens' initiative. The point is that year after year, now Delhiites, you know, wake up to a emergency situation of sorts the next morning post Diwali. The visibility, which is almost gone, we see it every year post Diwali. Of course, we wake up with a cough. We wake up, and you know, a lot of old people and children that we're talking about are getting a lot of respiratory diseases. A lot of hospitals that we go and visit, their emergency wards are overflowing with patients of respiratory disorder. But despite that, it's a pity that the citizens chose, you know, perhaps a temporary fun of bursting crackers over actually breathing in clean air. That, of course, hasn't happened. The point is that, again, we've woken up to a morning where the AQI levels have reached up to 999. Now, we do know that the AQI meters cannot read beyond three digits. And when I say they cannot reach beyond three digits, that means that we don't even actually know how bad the situation on the ground is. Now, of course, we're waiting for that crucial CSE report, which will be out sometime post noon, and then we'll actually get an accurate idea as to how bad the situation is this year. But with what we saw last evening, with the number of firecrackers we heard, it looks like the situation is pretty bad. The visibility, of course, is bad. But the point again is this pattern, this pattern of waking up to a morning which is so bad, the next morning of Diwali, needs to stop now.
Absolutely. You and I, Runjun, are breathing poison. I'm going to go over to Uday. Uday, we had Nityanand Jayaraman this morning, and you heard him say that even without Diwali, the national capital faces an emergency. It is hazardous to even visit Delhi, leave alone live in Delhi. And if people think this is just a winter problem and just a post-Diwali problem, he went on to say that they are highly mistaken.
Yeah, absolutely, Chetty. You know what Nityanand Jayaraman has said has essentially voiced the concerns of many activists who keep saying that the conversation around pollution, particularly air pollution, is only centered around these first 10 days of November. And then we also go on about our lives and, you know, we pay no heed to whether or not something needs to be done. And what many of them have said is that, yes, there are mechanisms in place to monitor pollution, but simply monitoring pollution is not enough. You know, you monitored and now the scale shows you 999. What does that mean? Where do you go from there? What do you plan to do to tackle that pollution? And what India lacks, what many activists say that India lacks, is a national action plan. For example, like the one that China had. You know, South China, for example, has reduced levels of pollution significantly. Why can't Delhi and why can't India do the same? And that is what activists are saying, that yes, you are monitoring pollution, but what do when pollution levels breach the scale itself? 999 is unheard of, Chayati, and this is exactly the kind of air that we are breathing. As you rightly mentioned, what we are breathing right now is poison.
Runjan Sharma is also live with us from Akshardham. Runjan, Uday says there has to be a call to action for the right to breathe as well. What are you picking up as far as the sentiments of people are concerned? Because, you know, even people ended up flouting the norms while there were manufacturers and retailers still continuing to defy the Supreme Court orders. You also had people flouting the norms of the Supreme Court, despite the Supreme Court saying, look, these are the time slots and only green crackers are going to be allowed. But we saw the citizens also flout norms. We saw the enforcement being very poor of the Supreme Court order as well. What is the sentiment of people at large in New Delhi at this point of time?
You know, of course, like you said, it's easier to point fingers at the judiciary and say that they haven't made very, very implementable rules. Now, it's easier to point fingers at the government and say that, you know, where is the government? Why isn't it doing anyone? But what about the citizens? The point is that we live in the city. We know how bad the situation really is. And we're not talking about this year. It's a year after year practice now where we know that we're breathing really in a poisonous gas chamber. Now, experts have gone on to say that it's an emergency-like situation. It calls for a complete city shutdown. Experts, in fact, are urging people to stay indoors. The point is, despite the situation being so bad, why is it that the citizens are flouting the norms? Now, when we say flouting the norms, these are two things we're talking about. A, flouting the cap of the 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. cap, which was given by the Supreme Court, 2 hours. We know that we heard people started bursting crackers way before 8. They kept on bursting crackers way after 10 p.m. That's one. And two, you know, green crackers were the only crackers that the Supreme Court of India had allowed, if at all they wanted to burst in this time cap. Now, the point is that we went from one market to the other in Delhi. It is really rare. The green cracker in the market was something which is really rare. The manufacturers kept on saying that there are no green crackers in the market. The customers and the police was as confused as the manufacturer were about the green cracker. So we do know that the crackers that were the citizens were bursting last night were not really green crackers. They were regular crackers. And which is why we've again woken up to a morning which looks like this. The visibility is down. It's post 9. It doesn't look like 9. We barely see the sun here. Now, of course, I woke up with a really bad cough, and it goes for several people. Now, I was speaking to a few doctors earlier today, and what they're telling me is as expected, their emergency wards are overflowing with patients of respiratory diseases. And that's something that could have been avoided if A, the enforcement of the Supreme Court order was better, and two, if the citizens took up the initiative. And, you know, of course, I'm going to say being a little more sensitive, not to yourself, but also the children and the elderly people that live in this society, in this city.
Absolutely, Runjan. Very well pointed out right there. As you can see behind Runjan as well, there's an absolute haze. The sun has come up. It's 9:25 a.m. and you can see the thick plunge of smog right behind Runjan, where she's standing at this point of time as well, only showing you how bad the pollution levels in the national capital are this morning. We'll continue our continuous coverage on the right to breathe.